Here's a question for you. Does your website actually do what you need it to do for your business? Or is it really just a glorified brochure that nobody really reads? If you're a personal or business brand and you want to make the most of your online presence, then you're in the right place because today I'm going to give you 7 quick tips to optimize your website and also to differentiate yourself in the digital landscape. And if you hang around, there is an 8th bonus tip that is particularly relevant in today's frontier of AI. If you're running any kind of online business, your website is still one of the most important parts of your marketing. It's still the first place most people go to find out more, and it's a chance where you can really grab their attention and get them on side. Sadly, for a lot of brands, it's more of a missed opportunity. But here are 7 quick wins that will help you make more of an impact with your website. Number 1 is to make sure that your website is optimized for mobile. Now, whether we like it or not, most of us these days spend an extraordinary amount of time on our phone, and that includes browsing websites. And in fact, depending on what region you're in, the statistics from last year show that website traffic, between 35% and 65% of it is viewed on mobile devices. So that means that at least a third of your audience or potential audience is going to look at your website on their phone. So make sure it is optimized for them as well. Number 2 is to make sure that you highlight the benefits and not just the features of working with you or buying from you. So this is something that has more to do with your copy than anything else, but it's something that's often overlooked, particularly on website homepages. Just like a sales page, your main headline, your hook on your website is one of the first things people will see, and it's your first opportunity to get them to stay and feel like they're in the right place. This is where knowing your audience really well comes in. Make sure that that first headline really speaks to them. Make sure that you draw from pain points or their dreams or objectives to really ask them a question or put a statement there that makes them feel like they are absolutely in the right place and you're talking directly to them. If you can get them to answer a question with a resounding yes, then it means that they will feel they're in the right place. Don't tell them that you sell face cream. Ask them if they want to feel more confident when they look in the mirror every morning. Number 3 is to tell them what the plan is. So this little gem comes from Donald Miller, who's the author and founder of StoryBrand, and he's a marketing expert in online marketing. He identified that people respond positively when presented with a plan. People want clarification before they take the next step. So present them with a simple plan that shows them what the next steps are. You don't have to outline the entire process, but just make it feel like there is a plan and that it's achievable. A great example of where this is done well is in the car industry. Now, the process of buying a car is not particularly simple. There are a lot of steps to go through. But you will notice that on the majority of those websites, they talk about coming in to view the car, making your offer, and driving away happy. It's not all the steps, but it makes it feel incredibly achievable, and it makes people feel like they know exactly what the process is and they're in safe hands to take the next step. Number 4 is to minimize choices and distractions. Presenting people with more choices is actually not a great thing. I don't know if you've ever heard of the Hicks Law. It basically states that the more choices you give people, the harder it is for them to make a decision and the longer it takes for them to make that decision. Presenting people with too many options also increases the likelihood that they will want to go away and think about all those options, and that will often mean that they don't take action straight away. Now, when it comes to your website, especially your homepage, one of the best exercises you can do is to think about, if you could only get them to do one thing, what do you want them to do when they hit this homepage? It's a great exercise in minimizing all the other things that you want to present them with and just making sure that it's really clear to them what action they take when they hit your website. The same, of course, goes for your navigation. People have got very comfortable with on-page navigation. They don't need a list of 50 different pages at the top of your website. All that does is immediately overwhelm them and feel like they'll come back and have a look later, which a lot of people never do. Keep your main navigation as simple as possible and make sure that it focuses on what your audience is looking for, not necessarily all the information you want to present to them. As always, keep it simple and think about your audience. Number 5 is to make your content scannable. People don't read websites the way that they read other materials. Research shows that people go from scanning web pages to actually reading the copy when the layout indicates to them where the relevant sections of interest are. So make sure that your web page is scannable by using headers, paragraphs, formatting, and the layout to break up information and help people easily find the content that's relevant to them. We want people to stop scanning and to read a little deeper. So make sure that we make it easy for them to find the content that's relevant to them. Number six is to make your call to actions really obvious. Use color, size, and white space around them to draw attention to your call to action buttons or links. This is, after all, the whole point of your website, is to get people to take some kind of action. Just like on your sales pages, you want to make it easy for people to take action, to buy from you, or to find out more. Number seven is to think about accessibility. So this is an important one for me. For a long time, technology companies really neglected huge sections of society. But fortunately, tech is catching up, and AI tools are making it much easier for companies to make their tools and their products and their websites more accessible to a broader range of people with different abilities that are neurodiverse, people who up until now have not really been able to access the same materials that you and I have. Now, the truth is that everybody deserves the opportunity to access the incredible information that's on the internet. And that goes for your website, your brand, your materials too. I believe we all have a responsibility to help make that happen. And that's where accessibility comes in. Check your website to make sure that there is suitable or sufficient contrast in the colors that you use. Make sure that you add alt text to your images. Make sure that the text is large enough that the majority of people find it easy to read, even without using accessibility features that a lot of websites have. These are simple things that can have such a profound impact on the audience that is trying to reach you. Plus, for a lot of industries, it is becoming legally necessary for you to make sure that your websites are accessible. So if you can get ahead of that curve, it's not only a great thing to do for the people who need access to this information, but it will also help you future-proof your website. These seven things are things that I so often see really overlooked on a lot of people's websites. And as I say, I think it's the real difference between taking your website from being a brochure that nobody really reads to something that people actually spend time on, and more importantly, that prompts people to take the action that you want them to take. If you want more tips like this and more information about up-leveling your design and your website and your branding, then please hit the like and subscribe button below this video. And also sign up to my Meaningful Creations newsletter. It goes out every week, and it's got insights on design and trends, as well as information to help you uplevel your brand and business. Now, I promised you there would be a bonus tip. Number eight is about being human. Now, let me explain. Increasingly, people are using AI to help them write content. And honestly, it is a fantastic tool if you want to do that. However, as with anything, it is being abused, and people are literally using the exact copy without amending it to create blog posts and other web content. Now, while that may help them short term, Google have already said that they are using their own AI to detect copy that is written by AI. And those kind of websites and those materials will not rank as highly on Google. Your differentiator is who you are, what you know, and your viewpoint. So make sure that you use that copy as a base, but that you actually make it human and make it from you. This goes for terminology that you use on your website as well. Again, search engines are trying to show people what they search for. If you're using a lot of jargon and incredibly fancy language on your website, there is a good chance that it's not the kind of language people are searching for, so you're not going to rank well. Think about what your audience is searching for and use those terms on your website. Now, I know I've focused mainly on how this impacts SEO and search results, but the other thing, of course, is that people respond well to language that connects with them and the language they speak. If you can talk to people in a way that really shows you know them and that they feel they are connecting with a human, it immediately just builds relatability and also trust. And as we've talked about before, trust is absolutely essential when you're building an online business or brand. That's it, folks. I hope these tips were helpful. Drop a comment below the video if you have any questions about the tips that I've shared in this video. And of course, please just drop a comment if you have any other tutorial videos that you would like me to create going forward. Have a fantastic week, and I will see you soon.